Hey guys, welcome back to the Fire and Rice podcast.
What's up?
We are back with more, you know what it is, American Idol.
Oh boy, do we have an interesting episode for you guys this week.
Oh boy.
So, first off, episode 3, last week's episode, some of you might have seen it already, but if you didn't, it was actually removed off of YouTube due to copyright.
Ooh.
Whatever. So Yikes. The video got taken down. I went ahead and disputed it. I kind of understand the reasoning behind it as to why it got taken down, but
yeah, of course.
We're going to definitely try our best to make sure that moving forward, none of our videos get taken down. So yeah, if you haven't seen it, definitely click down below and check out the channel and watch episode 3. But as a recap, episode 3, we were talking about the top 10.
Mm-hmm.
And this past week, episode 4 for our podcast is going to be about Disney Week.
So, woo! Disney Week!
Yeah, definitely a really fun, kind of unique episode.
Oh yeah, for sure.
And so we'll...
Because they didn't have Disney Week before when it was on Fox, but now that it's on ABC...
Yeah.
Disney.
Yep. So, yeah, that was this week, and that's what we're going to be kind of talking a little bit about.
Yes.
And if you did watch episode 3, you know that we went and had a little bit of a mix and mingle,
yes.
I think is what they officially called it. So we'll kind of talk a little bit about...
It was the American Idol listening sesh.
Yeah, there you go. That's, I think, the official name, was it? Yeah. What's that over there?
What's that?
Stay tuned. We'll open
ABC.
Up the envelope in a little bit. We may have some results. I'm just kidding. Okay.
Also, I'm not wearing a onesie this week.
Oh, yeah.
I ran out of characters. Now I'm a normal person.
People have been commenting and guessing what the next onesie was going to be. So we may have to...
Have to reach out to my supplier.
Oh, she has a supplier now.
I do. Oh. They've been supplying me for the past 2 years.
Oh, well, then we should definitely see if we can get some. And then we can talk to them about...
I usually just like a bunch of their stuff like in a row when I'm feeling like getting a new onesie. And then they're like, hey, want a new one?
We can totally work something out with them for this whole thing. Very cool. Okay.
They're really cool. Anyways, continue.
So, no, that's all good. Well, what I want to do is just cover a few of the performances from Disney Week.
Mm-hmm.
And this time we won't be watching the full performance. We'll just kind of watch a little bit of it and just for the sake of... the copyright stuff.
Right.
So let's pull those up real quick. This first performance that I wanted to showcase coming from Wade doing You've Got a Friend in Me from Toy Story.
Yeah.
So let's go ahead and take a look.
Bit. Look at that smile.
So just a full-on classic, you know, definitely.
Yes.
And that right there, he has Andy on the bottom of his shoe.
I know.
That
he
is such,
that
it's just like
to wardrobe.
Such a wholesome idea to include something like that.
Mm-hmm.
It just adds so much more to the performance, in my opinion. Great song choice.
Yes.
Honestly, that's like the best fitting song that, you know, he could get. You know, if you want to see more, definitely go to the American Idol YouTube channel. Check out this performance. We'll have a link to their channel in the description. But when you watch this video and you watch this performance, he's just smiling the whole time. And he's just so happy. And like, I don't know, for me personally, I could just feel that.
Yeah.
And this song in particular, I love playing this one on the piano. It's just like my favorite Disney song, kind of my go-to party trick on the piano.
Mm-hmm.
And so for me, it was like to see him do this, I was just really happy. I don't know.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I agree 100%. I also just realized I forgot to say I'm Jenna. And that's Jack, aka TorchHD.
Oh, yeah, we never did our.
Sorry.
Whatever. That's fine. We're going in a different order. Anyways, it's a lot later than normal that we're doing our recording. So
exactly. I just got back from LA.
Yeah, we're definitely a little bit
wonky.
Yeah.
Just a little bit.
Things are going to get weird this episode.
Maybe even.
What was that?
Maybe even itchy cream weird.
Like the sabotage? Yeah. Oh. Hey, man. If y'all, whoever is listening to this, if it was because of the sabotage thing that we said with the itching cream,
we didn't mean it, bro. Don't take down our videos just because of that.
Okay, well, anyways, great performance from Wade. Let's move on to another one here. This one I have queued up is Lacey K. Booth. I See the Light from Tangled.
It's my favorite movie, my favorite song, and it's just so beautiful. And Lacey looks so beautiful in that dress, her outfit, her whole getup. Gorgeous. Play. How do you think they did that?
Just an overlay on the camera, I think.
I was really confused.
You thought it was real?
No, I knew it wasn't, but
it definitely isn't in the crowd. Yeah. It's definitely in the background of the shot. But this is just an overlay, I think.
Okay.
CGI'd on top, I guess you could call it. Well, like you said, I mean, in this performance for sure, she definitely looks, and they even say it, just like a full-on Disney princess. And I don't know. I mean, her voice is so unique, and she puts like this, her own spin on this song, and yet it feels right.
Yeah.
For sure. You know?
Even though she has her own unique, distinct voice, and I don't know. I just felt like it really matched well.
Yeah. I think so too. I don't know. Just it's her voice is so soft and a little bit raspy, and
yeah, I want to say like smoky.
Yeah, you could use the word smoky for sure, but it has this sincerity to it.
I guess it's because the original song isn't like that. And then you think of Lacey's voice and then you think, how's this gonna pair up? But clearly, it's a masterpiece.
Yeah, I'd say so. Yeah. I think it turned out pretty well.
Yeah.
So, we got one more from the Disney.
The chopstick claps.
Yeah, we should probably. I'll clap for this one as well. So the other performance from the Disney night that I want to showcase, our friend. Can we call him our friend?
Who?
Walker Burroughs.
Walker Burroughs. Go ahead, play.
Okay. This is going to be Walker performing When She Loved Me from Toy Story 2, aka, I call it Jessie's song.
Yes, Jessie's song.
You can call it that. All right.
When somebody loved me, everything was beautiful. Every hour we spent together lives within my heart. And when she was sad, I was there to dry her tears. And when she was happy, so was I. When she loved me. Through the summer and the fall, each other, that was all, just she and I together, like it was meant to be. And when she was lonely, I was there to comfort her. And I knew that she loved me.
You should cap it before we get copyrighted. Before it's too late.
I think we're going to be okay this time. I hope so. We're okay. Definitely changing up. This is more of an experimental episode just to see what happens with this. With this video.
No onesies, not so many jokes. I mean,
well, okay, so this is,
or
actually,
not so many theories, I should say.
Hey man, conspiracies are a good thing sometimes.
Yeah.
No, let's talk about this performance. Right. So this is another one of the songs that I like to play on the piano.
Yes.
I don't know, maybe it's just a Toy Story.
I was gonna say
it's got to be a Toy Story thing,
for sure.
Because this is another one, a great song to play on the piano. Obviously the backtrack itself is primarily almost all piano. I don't know, I think his voice is just, we've talked about it so many times, mm-hmm. it's so easy to listen to. It's got this like just slight, I don't know what the word is, I want to just use, like, there's just this class to his voice where
Michael Bublé.
Yeah, a little bit of Bublé, but just very easy listening kind of style of voice.
Yeah.
Personally though, I would say, and I think I said this when we watched it live, was I kind of wish he took more artistic like liberties with the song, in that maybe he drew out some of the notes more, maybe he kind of was a little more patient on certain parts. It almost felt a little bit rushed, but, you know, it could be attributed to nerves, of course. But overall, still, I liked it. I think if he can get his own kind of artistic self going.
Mm-hmm. But it's also, when you're on stage, it feels like forever.
That's,
you know?
True.
So even when it does feel rushed to, say, the audience, to him, it feels like he's, you know, playing
right.
it out. So,
right.
yeah, I don't know. I guess it's just it's just something that he has to play with.
Sure.
A little bit more.
Yeah, makes sense. So, with that being said, those are the three performances that I just want to point out for this video coming
from
the Disney night. So, the Disney Week episode ended with the top 10 going down to top 8.
Mm-hmm.
Two left the competition.
Yes.
One was Uche,
mm-hmm.
and the other was Demetrius.
Yes.
Uche sang a song from the Goofy movie,
yes.
Eye to Eye.
Yeah.
Which,
unfortunately, nobody could relate to because nobody knew it.
Right. I think that was probably where he went wrong.
Yeah.
Picking a song that not too many people know, especially on the Disney episode where, like, almost everybody should know the songs that are being sung, you know? He definitely picked a very obscure one, and I think that kind of cost him a little bit. Well, it did cost him the whole thing. to be completely honest. And literally, it cost him the whole thing.
He stayed true to who he was.
True.
And that's all that matters.
Right.
And he was happy with what he had done. So.
Yeah. I mean, he put on a great performance.
Yeah.
But I definitely think it was...
It was a choice.
It was a choice. Yes. And then the second contestant that departed from the show, Demetrius.
Yes.
Performing from Tarzan.
Yeah.
You're in my heart. Oh, so you're going to sing it. What are you doing? Why are you moving your mouth that way? What are you doing? What was that? Yeah, that song. No, you don't get any chopstick claps from me this time. No.
Is that Phil Collins?
No.
Oh, sorry.
Phil Collins did Strangers Like Me.
Oh, Michelle says yes.
He did.
Michelle says yes.
Phil Collins did You'll Be In My Heart? Oh. Oh. Okay, we're getting confirmation that Phil Collins did the whole thing.
Anyways, Demetrius, his performance, I thought it was very heartfelt, especially when they played the pre-tape package beforehand.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, and, you know, he had a day at Disney with his mom, and it was very nice to watch, and it warmed my heart a lot. And then he went into that song, and every song he sings, he dedicates it to his mom.
Yeah, it's definitely very sweet. And I thought that it was a step up from his performances.
His most recent performances.
Yes. Yeah. So it was definitely a step up for me. I personally liked it, but it definitely sounds like the America vote didn't, unfortunately.
Yeah, but I also did some research with Instagram because I'm about that stuff, and he didn't have as big of a following as the other contestants.
Sure.
So that played a huge role in it.
Right, and that's definitely something that we've been kind of thinking more and more about as the episodes go on, is who has the following to kind of help back them in terms of the America vote, because it's very apparent with certain individuals that they have a huge following, or at least a loyal following, to help them get the
propel them
right
in the competition,
right, to keep them in. An interesting thing too about this week was the judges have one unanimous judge vote save.
Yes.
One save once
for the rest of the
season. Only one. All three have to agree on it, and they did not save either.
No.
I definitely thought they might save Uche this week.
But they had already saved them. I feel as though, from a judge's standpoint, if we have saved you once and America still isn't feeling you, then
yeah,
I don't know if you should have a second chance.
Yeah, no, I see what you're saying.
Or we could save it along the road for somebody else.
Sure, sure. And it is just a one-time thing, so it is a very tough decision to make.
And it was the first cuts from the 10.
Yeah.
So they want to see what they can do.
Right, yeah. Well, I don't know. It's getting tough to guess who's going next,
yeah, I don't honestly. Know. I don't know. Honestly, this group of talented individuals have won it already.
Yeah, I think they're
like,
all
they
so
honestly
different.
Have
yeah, they're all so different in their
point.
Own right that
yeah.
At this point, it's just, yeah, it's hard to decide who will win and who's going to be getting sent home in the next weeks, because they're all so good.
Mm-hmm.
They're all so good.
Mm-hmm.
So it's going to be a really tough competition, but that's going to make for really good TV watching. I don't know. What do you want to call it?
TV watching. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Producers,
it's going to
be
a
happy.
Good show. Yeah, basically. Well, that kind of segues a little bit. Top 8 segues a little bit into
Top 8. Yeah, I was making an 8.
Oh, that's just like a circle.
Well, if you look at this and then like Top 8.
Okay.
Anyways, go ahead.
No, that segues into what we did over
right.
like kind of the weekend-ish.
So after, so we stayed in a hotel and we watched the Disney Night episode in the hotel. And then the next morning, we had our listening sesh.
Right.
And in between that, I only got 2 hours of sleep because I had a ghost encounter in the hotel.
Yeah, that kept us up too.
Yeah, nobody slept that night.
No, so it was definitely a pretty rough morning, but it was still a really cool experience.
Yes. I actually wasn't feeling up to meet anyone new that day. I was like, okay, I'll go. I'm not really feeling social. I'm not really feeling up to talking to anybody.
Yeah.
But I'm so glad we went.
Yeah, it was a really, really cool,
really cool
event.
Man.
You want to show what's in our
yes.
envelope? This was one of the goodies that we got as we left the listening session. An ABC
envelope.
And
the envelope. Winner of American Idol is... Just kidding. It says American Idol, the listening session for 2219 with a golden ticket.
Psych.
This is it.
We're going to be on the show next season. Again, another psych. We're not.
We're going to Hollywood.
Yeah. It's actually a very like hefty, thick
card. You know, yeah,
card.
It's thick.
Oh, focus. Hello? Can we focus, please?
Hello?
Focus on this.
I think that's okay.
There we go.
There.
No.
Oh.
Help us.
Say, I'm pretty sure that's the issue.
This is
right
the issue.
There.
Hide it.
That is the issue.
We can't have this anymore here. Focus.
There we go. Okay. Let me just put that away. Go ahead. Go ahead. Say what you
anyway,
need to say.
Anyway, so yeah, I kind of just want to talk a little bit about what we did. I mean, it was really interesting because leading up to the event, I was just telling myself, oh, you know, I'm not going to be starstruck or whatever. They're just normal people competing on this show, whatever.
On national television.
Yeah, they just seem like normal people. And yeah. I was like, eh, whatever. I won't be that nervous. The second we walked in the door, on the couch, I see Lacey K. Booth. Standing up, I see Wade Cota. And then in the far back, I see Alejandro. And out of nowhere, I froze. I legit had no idea what to do, what to say.
You did look a little tense.
I was very, very tense.
You looked very tense in the chestal area.
Yeah, I was just...
And your eyes were like darting everywhere.
Yeah, because I was like, oh my gosh.
Like, oh shoot.
That's
oh, shoot.
So-and-so. That's so-and-so. That person. That's that person. And I was like, oh no. Yeah. This is going to be a rough afternoon.
It's going to be a rough few hours.
Yeah.
How long was it?
It went like 11 to like, 2? Or? Yeah, it was like 11:45 till about like 2 in the afternoon. So it was only like a little over 2 hours. But let me quickly pull up some of the pictures that we took on screen. It's just a little slideshow that's going to be rotating through. But we met all of the top 8. Got the chance to pretty much... it was like a pretty much an open... like, what do you call it? Open floor to just...
Yeah,
walk
okay.
up.
Because the thing is, it wasn't open to the public.
Right.
This was an invite only kind of thing. Right. And so, for social influencers and press. And so, it didn't really feel like a meet and greet per se. It really was like a mix and mingle. There was a bar. They were serving drinks and food, sliders, little poke bowls, etc. Yeah. And so, and a lot of my friends were there and were like, what, like 12 years old?
You're not actually 12.
No. But like a lot of us who are 13, 14, 15, 16 were there. I felt like that took up the majority of the people there, along with press.
Yeah, definitely
that
younger. Definitely younger.
Yeah.
Influencers or whatever you want to call them, mm-hmm. and like you said, press over there. So it was really cool, though. I mean, we pretty much it was like I said, it was open to. Like an open floor to just be able to walk around, talk to people.
Yeah, because it was at a recording studio in LA.
Yeah.
So it was kind of the open, but it was pretty small. It felt really intimate because of the lighting, and
it was
really
very,
dark in there.
Yeah, some of
like
these pictures have terrible lighting,
oh, yeah.
but it was like UV
oh
blue
God, look,
light. Yeah, this is a horrible photo, but like UV blue light, whatever, and it was dim and... there weren't too many seats, so people were either on their feet or just...
There was a couch in the middle.
Yeah, it was a little bit of a weird layout, but it was still really cool to be able to just simply walk up to...
But it felt so casual. That's
it was
what
very
felt
casual. That's
it.
A good word.
Like, I
it was very casual.
It was way better than just having a bunch of stiff chairs, like fold-out chairs around, you know?
Yeah.
Having that casual setting kind of made it more natural.
Yeah, it definitely was... different from some of the other meetups that I've, you know, done.
Mm.
I'm very interested in, like, the Twitch and gaming realm, YouTube gaming realm.
Conventions?
Yeah, so, like, they have meetups there, but they're more like, line up, walk up to them, shake their hand, say hello, take a picture.
Yeah, no, this
was
one,
it. This
like,
was, like, an actual, just chill. Like,
yeah.
Chill.
Like, we had drinks and stuff. Obviously not me, because I am under 21.
Yeah.
And I don't know.
Yeah.
Yeah, and food. So it's very like I said, casual.
Yeah, but all the contestants were there, and then at a certain point the judges came out.
Because after the performances.
Which we'll show.
Yes, which we'll show. They had live performances. That's when Katie and Lionel and Luke came out.
Yeah. They did their own little
structured panel with a moderator.
Mm-hmm. Cool. And then they were also just kind of hanging around to meet up, and here's you with Lionel Richie.
Yeah, we talked about Club Mickey Mouse.
Yeah,
because in the panel he was talking about how he would watch the Mickey Mouse Club growing up. I don't recall why that came up.
Yeah, I don't know. He ended up mentioning what's her name?
Who? Brittany?
No.
Christina?
No.
Who?
Older.
Oh, Annette Funicello.
Yeah. She mentioned her and then somehow transitioned into the Mickey Mouse Club.
Yeah, the Mickey Mouse Club. And then all of us at Club Mickey Mouse looked at each other and were like, ooh, That's us. And then, no, we didn't do that while they were speaking, no. But then afterwards, Will and I went up to Lionel and we're like, hey, so you said the Mickey Mouse Club. Do you have that clip?
I don't have it here. It's on my phone somewhere.
I posted a little bit of it on my Instagram, so that's my Twitter. But it's still also my Instagram. Go check it out.
Yeah.
Yeah. We had a nice little conversation.
Yeah, it was really cool. He was definitely, it was, what was interesting to me was just how you see them on TV, the judges that is, they are that way in person. Like, yeah. Lionel loves talking and telling stories and giving like life words of wisdom.
He loved imparting his wisdom onto
us. And
yeah,
he was just talking to you guys generation. And what was really nice too, in my opinion, was just how engaged he was with whoever he was talking to.
Yeah.
He didn't put a time limit on it.
No.
Although he was, you know, forced to go do press during your guys' conversation.
Yeah,
but he said, it definitely
guys,
felt like
I have
he wanted to keep
do press,
going.
But we
yeah.
were like, no, we get it. Go.
Yeah.
It was interesting though, because we see Lionel and Luke and Katie and you think, oh, you're going to get starstruck when you see them. But to be honest,
they felt more. Yeah, I was less starstruck to meet them than I was the contestants.
It felt very natural to talk to them for some reason.
Yeah, I wonder if it's just.
Compared to talking to the contestants. I think it's because they've been more in the public eye, or maybe there's just a certain presence that they're used to talking to people versus the contestants who are still within that normality.
Normal person.
Exactly. Yeah. And so it's a little strange to go up to someone. Just, okay, imagine a random stranger on the street and being like, hey, man, I'm so-and-so. Like, you're a great person.
Yeah.
Just random person instead of, you know, someone who does have a celebrity and they're used to it.
Yeah.
So I think
and,
that's what
yeah, and I think it comes with the status, too. Like, you get your almost, like, press training or, like, your personality
yeah.
training.
I mean, they're
to...
still technically sequestered in this competition.
Right.
They haven't had... I mean, I'm sure they've had some sort of media training, but I don't think they've had the set final media training to be like, okay, now go out into the world and do this and that and talk like this and don't do this.
Right.
So, yeah.
Yeah. So that was definitely really cool to see Lionel Richie, and you guys were able to get a photo with Katy Perry.
Katy Perry, yep.
Yeah, that was really cool too.
If you want to see me talking to her about Club Mickey Mouse, once again, go to my Instagram.
Yeah, that was definitely a really good icebreaker to have, just talking about Club Mickey Mouse.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Because Gabe and Will were talking about how they danced for her at the Super Bowl a few years ago.
Right.
And then that's when they're like, oh, yeah, we're in Club Mickey Mouse, and here are our friends from Club Mickey Mouse. And then I just came in and I explained what Club Mickey Mouse is.
Yeah. Really cool, though. But, yeah, it was definitely... pretty interesting and cool experience, like I said. We were also what would you call it, like, yeah, I don't know, they also just had like these live performances. I don't know how to that's all it really was.
What else?
No,
what
I'm trying to like figure out they I was gonna say they graced us with a performance.
Sure, you can say that.
I don't know, maybe it's
100%. Yeah.
Yeah, okay. Well, okay. We were able to film a couple of those. So let's see. Who do I want to pull up here?
We were able to film.
We filmed all of them, but I wanted to just showcase a few.
Yeah.
What's cool is when we show these to, I don't think you can see it in the videos, the live band that you see on TV was there performing.
Yeah.
I thought that was really cool that they just have the same band. Makes
I mean,
sense.
I don't see why they would just...
No, I know, but like, okay, I don't know. It was really cool because I'm just...
You're like, oh, the continuity of...
That's what, yeah, it felt like that to me. It really did. It was weird. But
It was like if Jack was watching Breaking Bad and then the main characters decided to do a play and then they had the background extras there too.
Sure, I guess. I don't know. Whatever.
Yes.
Okay. Let me go ahead.
No, I understand that.
Yeah. Yeah. All right. Let me pull up. This is a video we have from Madison.
Madison Vandenberg. She's very sweet.
Yes, she is.
Sometimes I love.
So something to point out too is these live performances, they were songs that were already performed, I guess you could call it.
Except for Jeremiah.
That's true. But
yeah, besides that, I think everyone else did
songs that were already performed.
Yeah.
So it's kind of cool to see it in a live setting.
They sounded really good.
Yeah, that's the thing.
All of them sounded really good.
Yeah. And something too that I thought of was like, it's a really good, almost like just a practice session for them to be able to get like a, obviously they're performing live, but like in this really, really close, like
intimate
really
setting.
Intimate, it was almost like an unplugged, I mean, it's plugged in, but you know,
yeah,
whatever they call those sessions.
When you're doing it in front of a live audience and it's so many people that you can have a disconnect from them. Because when you're on stage and the lights are shining at you, you really can't see anything past.
Right.
You can't really make eye contact. You can see little shadows and silhouettes of people.
Yeah.
But when it's a setting like this, you see everyone.
Yeah.
And there were a couple people, not going to lie, who seemed disinterested. And you can hear people's phones going off with their alarms.
Yeah.
And so there were a few distractions here and there, and it was a good practice, I think, for them to see what it would be like to perform in such
a
setting.
Sure. It was, what was nice too with being so close and like personal with mm-hmm. them too is like you could, like you said, you know, you can actually see the faces of the people in front of you, and you can make eye contact with them. And some of them, like, once, you know, we were able to make eye contact with some of the performers, and like you could tell, like, oh, hey, like, I'm acknowledging you.
Yeah.
It was really cool in that aspect. At least for me, I thought that was pretty cool. So, let me pull up another one that we have here. This one's from Lane. Let me get that pulled up.
But yeah.
Yeah, it was just a really cool thing.
But yeah, it's different because during one of these performances, I saw my friends talking in the front, and I noticed one of the singers were actually just like looking down at them talking.
Yeah.
And so it's different. When you're on a stage with a huge audience, you're not paying attention to that kind
right.
of stuff.
Yeah. Takes a sip from his whiskey bottle, and this is what he said. I was born in the rain on the Pontiac train underneath the Louisiana moon. Don't mind the strain of a hurricane that come around every June. The high black water, the devil's daughter, she's hard, she's cold, and she's mean. What was that?
Whoa! I didn't notice that.
Me neither. I don't remember that at all. That performance, though, was actually the performance where I realized that the full-on band was there. I don't know. Because the guy that plays the guitar with the thing, I don't know what it's called. With making that cool little noise.
You should know. You played Guitar Hero.
Okay. That doesn't count. That definitely doesn't count. But yeah, it was really, what's really cool about this whole thing, you know, I'm going to keep saying it over and over, is like seeing them in this up close and personal setting, just being themselves in terms of how they perform.
Yeah.
And okay, and this might sound kind of messed up, but it's like, they all can sing. Like, they can sing. There's no, you know,
well, yeah, because
in the episode, like a couple episodes ago, right, we were saying that
they're like, we don't know if it's, this is their true voices or if there's something with the oh God, what is it? Production?
Yeah.
Of it, but there was something off in one of the episodes.
Yeah. I don't remember which episode of the pod. I want to say it was the last episode.
No, not the Disney one.
No, the last episode of the podcast.
Okay.
The last podcast episode where we were saying, like, something's wrong here, man.
Yeah.
But going to this, it's like, obviously I knew that they could sing.
Yeah.
But it's like, but it just reaffirmed the fact that it's like,
wow.
Nice job, guys.
Really
great
good.
Job. Yeah. Personally, it made me a bigger fan of some of them, too. So.
Yeah, exactly.
I think this whole experience, too.
Yeah.
Just being able to talk to some of them and really getting to know a little bit more about them, or just seeing their personality outside of the show,
mm-hmm.
Definitely made me a bigger fan of some of these contestants too.
Yeah.
So, but I got one more to show, and of course, how can we go an episode of our podcast without mentioning Alejandro? Right.
Of course.
All right. So this one, this is his
video. This dude is so chill.
Yeah.
He's so nice. So just laid back.
Shout out to Bobby Bones for the early roast in the morning.
Oh yeah, Bobby Bones opened it up with a little roast session.
Yeah, yeah. Bobby Bones was pretty much picking on everybody. Little live tune session.
I looked at you and I was like,
I told you to zoom in. I was like, you gotta get this. You gotta get this.
You can see one of my friends' heads just going.
Yeah.
And we get the full song.
Huh?
We get the full song.
Oh, yeah. This is an extra layer. Like,
wow.
Just crazy good. And it's cool because, you know, we got to listen to the full thing.
Yeah, because they usually cut it, I think, like a minute. I think you get a minute or a minute 30 with these kinds of shows.
Yeah.
Showcase. But
yeah.
You get a full song.
It's yeah.
Really nice.
Especially considering we haven't heard that one since the audition.
Yeah.
And, I mean, that's the one that kind of got him on the radar
exactly.
In the first place, especially for us.
Yeah, you can definitely feel the You can definitely feel the energy in the room shift towards him. Like everything and everyone was looking at him.
Right.
Like being in a trance.
Yeah, I mean everybody.
I was hypnotized.
Yeah.
For 3 minutes, and I blacked out. All I remember are the sounds of the guitar.
I think that. Well, first, I'm definitely glad that we were able to record these because, personally, I've been, like, just listening to these just randomly.
Me too.
I just go through my phone, I'm, like, listening to these playbacks, and it's really cool. But, yeah, for Alejandro's performance in particular, what you said was just super true. As soon as he went up there, everybody pulled out their phone and wanted to get the video of him because I think everybody, like, is just in awe of him, his skill, his, you know, everything.
Yeah.
So that for me is just like a sign already of like he has a great following, or at least a great,
he has the it factor.
He has just he has a lot of votes is all.
Yes.
I'm gonna say he's
yes.
Got a lot of
we
votes.
We know that. Yeah,
for sure.
And judging on his Instagram account and his views on YouTube, it's safe to say that he will be making it pretty far in this competition.
Yeah.
Dare I say, the next American Idol.
Whoa.
Just solely based on my research.
Sure. That makes sense.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, so we got to meet all top eight.
Mm.
Now, what I want to do is actually revisit our top four predictions from last week, from the last episode, okay?
Do you have it written down?
I have the top four that we had.
Oh, goodness.
Okay. So, you said,
okay,
in particular order, your top four were as follows. Alejandro, Jeremiah, with Uche and Walker tied third, fourth. Okay. I put Alejandro Walker tied 1-2, and I put Uche Jeremiah 3-4.
Uh-huh.
So we had the same four, just in a different order. Now, the question this week that I have about top four, did it change? Yes. Obviously, it has to with Uche being gone.
Yeah.
But I just want to know what your top four is.
Yeah.
Now.
Yeah, man. Especially after meeting them.
Right.
Because we got that one-on-one interaction. Here are my top four.
Okay.
Tied.
In top to bottom.
In like, particular yep, order.
In particular order.
In one through three, I give you Alejandro, Walker, and Lane. Tied for first, second, and third.
Oh, boy.
And fourth, I have Lacey.
Okay.
I didn't get to talk to her much, but okay. I love her sound.
Right.
So much.
Yeah.
And she has a relatability to her. I think more so than Jeremiah now. I don't know why.
Okay.
I just feel that. I think that's all I have to say about that.
Okay. So my top four definitely change as well. So in particular order, I am putting Alejandra at number one still.
Okay.
I'm putting Walker at number two.
Okay.
I'm putting...
So it's the same so far from yours from last week?
No.
Oh.
Oh, yeah. Sorry. Yeah, you're right. But officially, I put them at tied.
Oh, okay.
Last
okay.
week. I put 1-2 tied, 3-4 tied.
Mm.
I'm actually saying Alejandro, top. Huh. Walker, second.
Yes.
I'm putting Lane at third.
Okay.
And I'm putting Jeremiah at fourth. I'm still keeping him in there. Because for me, I just think that although... So here's the other thing too, just kind of background at the meetup. He wasn't feeling so hot.
Right.
So he didn't really get like the chance to interact as much. We still got to talk to him and say hi and stuff like that. And he still performed. But he wasn't feeling as hot. So it was like I couldn't get a chance to really talk to him and really get to interact with him as much. But
he
just
was
based
so
on,
nice.
He was still really nice. But based on performance alone and just his... voice and all of his most recent perform. I mean, he's just outstanding.
He's a beast.
Yeah, an
he's
outstanding
insane.
Singer. So I'm keeping him in my top four.
I'm still looking at it from an Instagram standpoint.
And that's a good way to look at it.
Yeah, because I think Lacey has more of a following than Jeremiah.
Sure.
That's my only thing.
Okay. And that's a fair assumption and way to do it. I'm just looking at it from my perspective. Who I would vote for in terms of like my ordering.
Right,
but
right.
That's a really good way to look at it.
And then I see a lot of them promoting each other.
That's cool.
Yeah. And not so much in a way like, hey, vote for so-and-so, vote for so-and-so. It's more so just, hey, here's my friend. Here's me and my friend on the show.
Right.
Like Lacey and Lane did a duet
I saw
the other
that
day.
On Instagram,
covered,
yeah.
You know, not even for the show, just in general, you know, in their spare time.
Right.
So I thought that was really cool. And by doing so, they're cross-promoting each other.
Right.
They're pushing each
indirectly
other forward. Exactly,
promoting.
Indirectly. It's not like, oh, vote for us. No. You know, it's just like, here's us being organic.
Right.
And then all the fans go crazy.
Yeah.
And then you see Lane, Walker, and Alejandro hanging out. And once again, all the fans are like, oh, there's our top three right there. So, yeah. It's nice to see that friendship and that camaraderie amongst them.
Yeah.
It helps them, for sure.
It does. It gives you... It feels, again, like we've said before, it's like it feels less like a competition.
Yeah.
And just more of like this. For me, at least, it's like it's less of a competition and it feels more like just this kind of show, this like little breakout show where they're like showcasing these just really talented individuals.
Yeah. Because you see them on TV and it leaves you feeling like you want more.
Yes.
Like you want to see more into their lives. And so when you get to see them outside of that, and especially interacting with each other, then you get, I guess, more than what you asked for in a way. Like, oh man, I want to see more of Walker. Oh my God, I get to see Walker and Alejandro and Lane all together,
right.
You know?
Yeah, I see what you're saying now. Yeah, that's,
yeah.
It's really cool. It's really cool to see. And you could tell too at the meetup that They really are friends, like outside of the show.
Mm-hmm.
They were kind of like, you know, either during some of the performances, you know, we turned over and some of the contestants were standing next to us or sitting next to us and they were just kind of dancing or like cheering them on. And it was a really cool thing. And yeah, they were chilling. Mm-hmm. It was really cool to see. So, yeah, definitely a really, really fun event.
Yeah.
To have gone to. Very unique.
Yeah. Because I got invited last year, but I didn't go.
Yeah, you didn't really keep up with the season, so there wasn't really a point.
Yeah, there
really
was no point really for me to go.
You didn't feel connected. This season, we're keeping up with it. Obviously, we're doing the show, and it's like we're rooting for some people, and we're getting to like people more and more, and so...
I heard it was a lot better this year, though, than last year.
Yeah, that's what people were saying as well, so... I don't know. I hope that they do more like this in the future, and I hope that you get invited again in the future because you're the reason that we went.
Hopefully, yeah.
In the first place. So, who knows whether it's this season or in future seasons. It should be pretty fun. Yeah, I don't know. It was like every time I think back to it, I'm like, wow, that's really...
No,
it was just
really cool.
It was really cool.
Especially
just really...
because they're the future of music.
Yes.
And we know that for a fact.
Definitely. Definitely.
So, we get to see them kind of before their breakout.
Yeah, that's the kind of, and that kind of goes back to us saying how kind of they still have that normal person vibe to them, you know?
Normal person vibe.
Well, like they're not they're not at that full on celebrity status.
Yeah.
So they're more relatable in that aspect.
Mm-hmm.
So you can kind of... You don't see them as this, star.
As the American Idol.
Yeah, not yet, at least.
Not yet. One of them will be. All of them are. Oh, the camera kind of went out of focus.
Hello, camera.
Hello?
Figure it out. Focus.
Focus on May.
Focus.
F-O-C-U-S. Focus. Focus.
It's struggling.
Maybe there's a ghost.
I think we're just going to be out of focus for the rest.
No,
maybe
no.
That's our cue.
Please, no.
Is that our cue?
I don't even remember what I was talking about.
You were talking about the next American Idol, how all of them are going to be the next American Idol.
Oh, right. No, yeah, they've all become... I think they've all become American Idols in their own way. All right. Well, then maybe this is the cue.
Maybe our camera broke. That's unfortunate.
F-O-T.
Why won't this thing focus, man? Well, focus. Either way, I'm out of topic, so I don't know about
perfect.
You.
Perfect. There we go.
It's the book. It needs to be the book.
Okay.
Well, I don't know. I'm out of topics. Right. So yeah. I think it is our time to call it.
I think so.
With that being said, thank you all so much for watching. Definitely... check out the last episode if you didn't get to see it before, you know, before it got taken down. We're going to try our best to keep all the videos from getting taken down in the future. But
yeah, sorry if this was a little strange.
This episode
was a little unconventional, out of the sorts.
Yeah, definitely. I felt like having to change our little format made things a little difficult for me.
It's okay.
But it's okay. We're going to find a new style. We will adapt to this.
We're just starting, people. It will get better. We're here. It can only go up unless we dig a hole.
Which we might.
Which we might, but hopefully not.
Well, stay tuned for more episodes of Fire and Rice. We do appreciate everyone that does.
You didn't play our endorsements for Fire and Rice.
Oh, let me pull this
up. These are important. Don't leave yet. Please don't. Oh, man. I hope they didn't click out already.
Well, if they did, they missed out on a nice
then you missed out on something
secret Easter egg video that
for
we
those
got.
Those who only stayed till the end to see.
Well, we'll probably incorporate this in the next one, too.
True.
I'm going to try to. We're going to try to make this into an intro officially.
Of some sorts.
But look, it's our friend. Walker.
What's up, you guys? It's Walker here. You're watching Fire and Rice.
Awesome.
Awesome. Yeah, we got him to do a little intro. We got another one. Maybe we'll show that one on the next video.
Oh, yeah, maybe. Yeah.
Well, thanks for watching. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe. Let us know what you guys think. And we'll see you guys in the next video.
Woo-woo.